Memory is the storeroom of the mind. A dusty attic of experience stacked with knowledge. Sometimes useless, sometimes priceless. Once in a while, we must lift the shades, dust off the years, and with our souvenirs, seek to recapture the past. For there lies reason for the present and vision for the future.
Held that Donald Campbell has announced that he is to attempt raising his own record over 300 miles per hour. The attempt will be made at Coniston in Lancashire, where Mr. Campbell and his father Sir Malcolm have made several attempts in the past.
Donald put on his helmet, climbed into the cockpit, pulled the canopy over his head. But on this particular morning, he had a strange look on his face as he looked up to the pier at me.
Traveling quickly in itself, of course, is nothing. It's the challenge. It's like a mountain. It has to be climbed. There are songs that has to be written. Once mankind ceases to have the desire to do these things and progress, well, he'll stagnate and die very rapidly.
He perceived in the distance, he could hear the engine roar as it accelerated. The plume of spray.
Full power. I don't know, but I'm doing so much, but I think full power will do it. I'm trying to do it a touch. I'm going to be another brother around, yeah?
Then almost in sort of slow motion, he suddenly, you know, it slowly began to rise out of the water.
This is the terrible part about trying to break a record. You see, once you start, you're past the point of no return. And there's no going back. Once you start, you're past the point of no return. Past the point of no return.
You see this fantastic boat just become an aeroplane. Almost as if she's soaring off into the wild blue yonder.
Bluebird. Bluebird. Hello, the bluebird! Hello!
Oh, it's... Oh, God! He's blown up! She's run cartwheeling over and over. What a terrible disaster.
So Jack designed this amazing monument, people. So can you tell me what, Jack, we haven't got long. But, so what gave you the idea of this? Is this?
It's just the mere fact of to get people to try to get back on this particular day.
Yeah.
Bringing people to Dumbia, and that was the general idea of it.
Yeah. And how did you find this rock? Because it's in the shape of Western Australia.
A quarry over here.
Yep.
Select a big bit of rock and then took it into town and chipped away like an approximate Western Australia.
Cool. And you did all this yourself? Chipped it yourself?
Me and, Ron Lloyd and a friend called Bob Jones.
Oh, okay. Yep.
Yeah.
And you would have been here on the day that Donald Campbell...
No, I wasn't actually. I was developing new land out east.
Oh, okay.
And I was out harvesting.
So you were a wheat farmer originally?
No. I was in
Canada town. Oh, yeah. I remember that.
I loved farming. I did a little bit.
Yeah.
Because
I know you're an amazing mechanic. What you did to my old red purple Terra when I was a kid.
Yeah. It's amazing. We got on well together.
Oh, yeah. Everyone loved you, Jack. And Jack's wife, Judy, everyone, was my first ever school teacher when I was 6 years old, and that's Judy just there, and she hasn't changed a bit since I was a kid. But she taught everyone in for primary school, like kids in their 50s. So, beautiful lady. So you can just see right here now, fellas, this is the light shining here, and eventually the sunlight will shine onto the boat right here at 3:43.
Electronically judge the speed of it, like. And when, that's when they radioed back, you know, he's done it again.
Cool.
At 3:43, so that's when I got the time capsule. And I thought, well, for a little town like Dumbledore, put it on the map.
Yeah.
And by having something that happened every year at the same time.
Yeah.
You know, we might get more tourists into Dumbledore. I was on the tourist committee at the time.
And
every year we just keep wondering if it's going to keep doing.
And the original boat got stolen too, didn't it?
Oh yeah, we've lost about three boats.
Three boats?
Yeah, people come up and ship them off. We lost the whole park one time.
You're joking.
Took that. You look here, this one.
Oh yeah. So people have actually stolen the little boat in the middle three times. People, and they've replaced the boat, and they've also stolen the plaque before, or they've attempted to steal it before, which is very sad.
The sun comes or hits on the side, you can see a little bit coming down.
Yeah.
Between 3:43, it actually
falls
away.
Sure.
Jack bowls the boats each time they.
Oh, okay. Minutes, everyone, until the light shines on Donald Campbell's Bluebird boat, and 3:43 represents the exact time Donald Campbell broke the world water speed record on Lake Dumbuyung, which is over here.
It's 42,
Jack.
It's duller, okay? It's duller, isn't it? I don't know. Did you notice that yet?
What's that?
It's duller.
Yeah, very good.
It's usually quite bright.
It's hard to believe it happens.
So just here, everyone, this is the exact Bluebird replica, what's just recently been built. And it's on display here in this beautiful undercover shed for tourists and so forth to look at. So it's a beautiful tribute to Donald Campbell, who set the world water speed record on Lake Dumbuyung exactly 52 years today.
another age, another time.
A famous picture. Donald Campbell at the wheel of Bluebird on a dry lake bed in Australia.
The track dries. The wind drops. The bid can be made.
50 years ago, the technicians all wore white lab coats, even working in a desert. This film is a portrait of a different era.
It was designed to do 450 miles an hour, and the record now for a wheel-driven car is 458 miles an hour, so you can see how advanced the car was.
July the 17th, 1964. The car reaches 403 miles an hour.
All tyres and wheels must be changed. Engine checked.
To take the record, two runs must be made in opposite directions within an hour. The car goes again.
Accelerating again. 360, 370, vibrating, 380, vibrating severe. Still accelerating, 390, clear, can't hold up, parachute now.
The surface is rough. The tyres are in ribbons.
Success! A new world record. 403.1 miles per hour.
Today, the car has pride of place in the National Motor Museum at Bewley. Don Wales was six when his uncle died, but now holds land speed records himself in electric and steam cars.
I can remember standing next to the huge wheels, and they were taller than me, and I just looked up in awe at these fabulous wheels, not quite understanding what it was all about. And he lifted me up and put me in the cockpit.
Official timekeepers take up their positions.
Donald Campbell wanted to be the only person to take speed records on land and water in the same year. His craft, also called Bluebird, looked more like a plane than a boat.
A quick instrument check.
Time was running out. The final attempt was late afternoon on New Year's Eve on a lake in Australia.
Still accelerating 270, 275, 280, and I was clear with 5 seconds of fuel left.
The chief timekeeper radios the news. It's a new world's water speed record of 276 miles per hour.
The newly restored film, How Long a Mile, was directed by Donald himself. The credits, handwritten.
It's about time that people fully recognise that Donald Campbell should be remembered for that fabulous achievement, and not just for the crash that ended his life. He was supporting Britain and trying to achieve fabulous things way ahead of his time.
Paul Clifton, BBC South Today, Bewley.